Richardson, that's the countdown. John Richardson. Wilkinson. David Mitchell. Rasheed Hunnity. Tom Allen. Susie Biss. And Rachel Riley. Now, from your host, Jimmy.
Welcome to Editor Ten Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, the Egyptian hieroglyphic for a million is a man with his arms outstretched? When you think about it, hieroglyphics were the original emojis. Dog face, ra face, hashtag nice Nefertitis. Oceanographers have recorded dolphins having conversations in their own dolphin language. They'd been trying for ages and then suddenly it just clicked. Foca is a Spanish word for a fat person and literally translates as seal. It can be used in phrases such as, look at my Spanish friend, Jose. He's a right fat foca. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's John Richardson. John was born in Lancaster, which is about 3 miles east of Morecambe, 20 miles north of Preston, and 50 years behind London. And joining John tonight, it's David Mitchell. Looking at David and John together there, just turn back the clock 30 years and you've got every bully's dream.
Interestingly as well, 30 years ago, I was 3 years old, so that's a pretty harsh bully.
Yes, I was. Up against them this evening, it's special guest team captain Joe Wilkinson. Joe Wilkinson is not only one of this country's finest comedians, he's also one of Britain's leading hedgehog sanctuaries.
I don't think that's not true.
And joining Joe tonight, it's Rasheen Connerty. Having Rasheen on Countdown is a real no-brainer because, well, let's just leave it there, shall we? Rasheen, you've not covered yourself in glory in the past on this show. Tonight, you're paired with Joe. Do you think you're going to do any better?
Yeah. I reckon it's our turn. It's our time, isn't it?
Are you sure it is?
I need a bit more time. It's a time problem.
Right.
I can spell over days.
It doesn't really go in turns.
What do you mean?
Well, it's not your turn, really.
It is my turn.
Well, that's sort of Darwinism.
Shut up, you square.
So you're going to have to clarify which square you're talking to. Yeah.
We're being bullied by the hedgehog sanctuary.
David, how would you celebrate if you win tonight? Sorry, David, how would you celebrate when you win tonight?
I don't think I will.
You won't celebrate?
I don't think I'll see it as much of an achievement.
I thought you meant you...
OK.
We've got a plan.
Yeah.
What is your plan?
Written down the alphabet.
To win it tonight, we're not mucking about.
Or second, whatever.
Joe, what's your idea of a romantic date?
Chicken Kiev, chips and peas. I always think you can tell when a date isn't going well when the other person deliberately licks an electric fence. shouldn't have taken her to the abattoir.
Which one should you have taken her to?
Well, it's a second date thing, isn't it?
You know. OK, John, you're generally quite a calm man. What was the last thing that got you really angry?
I saw a guy yesterday eating cashew nuts.
Sorry, how are you pronouncing the word before nuts?
Cashew nuts.
Cashew nuts?
No, you're doing it a bit too like a sneeze.
Cashew.
Cashew nuts.
Cashew.
Bless you.
Cashew.
And sorry, you were annoyed by a man eating cashew nuts.
Yeah, I hate seeing people eat healthily out. because it depresses me about what I'm doing with my life. It was like out, so it wasn't like at home, you know, when you have a healthy tea every third day, you think, oh, I better have some broccoli so I don't die. He was out and he was like, I could have a lion bar or some Monster Munch, and he had, however you say them, nuts. Oh, God, what a depressing world. At Surbiton train station eating cashew nuts in the afternoon.
Cashew?
He was eating walnuts. He was eating a box of pistachios.
I tried to eat a chocolate orange hole once. I got it in my mouth and I had to wait 6 days for it to melt.
Okay, Roisin, have you got a mascot?
Yes. So, my mascot is something I find very lucky in life all the time. I always get lucky when I have champagne. So, this is something that's very close to my heart. It's a really big, unopened bottle of champagne.
Who does that to the top of a bottle of champagne?
And, yeah, so it's a thing I find. It makes me... I get luckier, everyone gets luckier. Champagne for my real friends, real pain for my sham friends and all that. So, yeah, it's my mascot.
OK, David, have you got a mascot this evening?
Yes.
What have you got?
I've got these.
Oh.
Because I thought if I brought these, that it would allow other people to make sexual jokes. I don't feel very comfortable making sexual jokes myself. I'm a bit repressed. I find it very awkward. But I know people enjoy sexual jokes, and I thought I could contribute in a way by bringing these, and then it's an opportunity for other people to go, oh, I expect... I don't know, you were wearing them and being fucked. Jimmy, I thought this would be a wonderful opportunity, because you love making sexual jokes.
I do.
So
I do
please,
love making sexual
please
jokes.
Please say a sexual thing.
Don't worry, Jimmy, I've brought my lucky anal beads.
Okay, John, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I've developed, Jimmy, a game within a game.
Ooh.
What do we write our answers on here?
Paper.
Paper, yes. What do you do with the paper when you've finished?
Leave it on the desk.
Not anymore, Joe! I've brought my spangly hoop. This is my hoop, and what I'd like is at the end of each round, when all the paper is ready to go, that you try and put your waist in my hoop. So, I'm going to place the hoop out in the, what's that, the netherworld?
I think it's a pond.
Are you going ice skating? Okay. Oh.
Yes.
How did you do that?
I know, I was there and then I'm here now.
Right, okay.
I want some sort of momentum, so I slide it.
I'd go over the middle.
I'd go around if I were you.
No, you can go over. You could Starsky and Hutch it. Come on.
Oh, my God!
So, at the end of each round, you will be invited to throw your paper into my hoop. If you get the paper into the hoop, I will eat one of these disgusting foods which I have brought along, and you get to choose. So, here we have... There's a spoonful of wasabi paste. There's a lemon there. I'll bite into that. There's some chilies.
Don't play down the chilies, mate. There's some chilies. Forget those. That's all you're eating. Chili, chili, chili.
I didn't actually bring this one. That's your packed lunch that you've brought. There's a raw onion in there. There's some butter. Mm. And there's half a pint of cottage cheese.
Well, John, we look forward to playing that later. Joe, have you got a mascot?
Yep.
I
brought along one of my Countdown Russian doll sets that I've painted.
What's going on there?
As you can see, Jimmy, you are the main Russian doll. You're in one of your swanky suits. But as you can see, you've pulled your trousers down and you've pushed your testicles out the side of your face. So, inside Jimmy is Rachel. As you can see, Rachel is holding some toilet rolls under her arm because she steals the toilet roll after the show when she's pissed up. inside Rachel is Susie. Now, as we all know, Susie's a pervert. bit of a peeping Tom, that's why she's wearing some binoculars and she's holding a Polaroid camera. The reason she's holding a Polaroid camera is because she does this thing where she'll kick your dressing room door down and try and take a picture of you when you're changing. I've spoken to HR, but they're scared of her temper. And then finally is John.
You've done a life-size, John.
Yeah, I feel that one's sort of self-explanatory. As you can see, he's in his dinosaur pyjamas because he struggles to get adult clothes to fit.
He's watching Dolls, everyone. OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's Tom Allen.
Hello. Good evening.
Tom says he used to dress in Victorian clothing as a teenager to disguise the fact he was gay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Tom, that'll throw him off the scent.
Worked.
Tom, tell me about your love life. How's it all going?
That's a very personal question, actually, Jimmy. recently I've been dumped, but it's fine, it's fine. It was a mutual decision for him to dump me. No, we both sort of realised it wasn't working. Unfortunately, we realised at different times. He realised some weeks before. I realised when he told me. but it's fine, it's fine. You know, other, you know, good things have been happening. I've got one of these things now, which tells me how my heart's doing. Yes, still broken. So, no, don't patronise me. No, it's fine, it's fine. I have a couple on the show, it's fine, I'm happy.
OK, and with Tom, of course, is Susie Dent. Susie has written 14 books about the derivations of words, and you can find them all in your local library. Just ask for the Sleepy Go Bye-Bye section. OK, Susie, what have you been looking into recently? Other than glory holes.
Unnecessary joke.
Sorry, Susie. Okay. Now, what have you been looking into recently?
All the effect of my having brought me.
No, I've been looking into the language of doctors, which is quite interesting. Okay. But things like brothel sprouts.
Brothel sprouts?
Yeah, you know, doctors have these ridiculous names to try and, the black humour, sick humour, to yeah. try and, you know, keep the horrible stuff at bay. So brothel sprouts are basically genital warts. Sorry, I'm sorry to
make it up.
Yes, that's it, really. I'm just thinking glory holeness.
OK. And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. If you had to be stuck in a lift with any one of us, who would it be?
I think it would probably be Joe.
Yes.
It looks like he's been confined and escaped from somewhere before.
OK, tonight the prize the teams will be competing for is this, the Countdown Unicorn! OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. Joe, Roisin, you get the first pick of the letters.
Could I have a couple of good ones?
Both for him. An N. And an I.
And then a P.
I like P. I like P.
And then a const. Well, yeah, my name.
L.
And then a vowel, please.
U.
Consonant, please.
W.
These are horse shit.
Give us a cheeky I.
Yeah, yeah. What do we need an
E.
I?
That'll do.
That's an E, love. consonant.
Deep.
And then a vowel.
And
please.
O.
OK, and for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. Does anyone want candy floss?
Yeah.
OK.
Perfect.
One for me.
Roisin, how many letters?
Five.
Ooh, I feel like one of the Simpsons. there you go.
Thank you very much.
OK, Joe, how many letters?
Seven.
No, how many letters did you get?
Five.
John, how many?
Seven.
David?
I think I've got a seven.
OK. Roisin?
Wired.
OK. Joe, you're five?
I've got a risky seven. No, it's horseshit. It's not even close. that's not a word, is it?
Yeah, it is.
All right, seven. Unlower.
Unlower. Susie, unlower.
No.
John, you're seven?
Rewound!
I'm sorry, what was that?
Rewound!
Rewound.
That's probably a word, isn't
it? Yeah, it is, yeah.
Oh, fuck.
Roisin, you've annihilated that.
Wait, when did you eat that?
you don't give me food and expect it to last. That's why I've got massive teeth.
OK. David, you're saying...
Unwired.
Susie?
Yeah, it's in the dictionary.
Oh, you shit.
You can't be serious. Unwired's a word.
I'm not allowed unlower.
The rationale, I think, is that unlower isn't a word and unwired is a word.
Oh, use your facts, mate.
OK, 7 points for John and David. So Tom, Susie, could they have done any better?
Mm-hmm.
No, well, sevens.
Oh, no, they could have done the same. Yeah, yeah. More sevens.
Down here. Is there. And one for Joe, weirdo.
It's time for a round of In My Hoop.
Yes.
Oh, lovely.
Ooh, yeah. A lovely little round of In My Hoop.
And the good news is I've just eaten all that candy floss, so I'm definitely going to puke if you get one in.
OK. All right, so on three, everyone.
Are we doing it all together?
One, two, three.
Yes!
Joe, I think you get to choose what he eats.
Butter. I'm going to make you eat butter.
Don't go.
Let's go chili.
Chili.
Chili, Joe.
All right, chili, yeah, because that's...
You choose. Choose a big one. Choose a big one.
Yeah, choose a big one. Choose a nice big one.
Stick in wasabi.
There you go. Stick that. Here come the liquid stool.
Yeah. Yeah, the sad thing is, this isn't even the worst bit. There'll be no cameras on tomorrow.
Oh, I don't think there's water. There's no water involved here.
Oh, for God's sake, he's a human being!
Oh, that's been really good, wasn't it, watching him do that? Let's have some champagne.
Yeah.
Okay. OK, so at the end of that, John and David are in the lead with 7 points.
Will you, for the love of God, pour that fucking champagne?
OK, I'm not allowed about to let it spill, so I'm being very...
Hey, the shit! Tell me you're doing it!
Sorry.
Well, they're just all foam for him.
David, that's for you.
Right, this is going to take ages.
Okay, it can happen. Okay, on to our first numbers round. Okay, John, David, your turn to pick the numbers.
I'm tempted to say all from the bottom, but I think that's my chilly speed.
One from the top and any other four, please.
So, and then another.
And then a bonus one.
Do you want that one?
Bonus one is one.
One. Oh, the worst number.
Nine.
The ninth worst number. I
seven.
Hate seven.
Brilliant.
I feel about five.
Five. Five actually is a favourite of mine. Five gold rings.
Good.
100.
226.
Okay, and your time starts now. So the target was 226. Roisin.
Start the other end.
I'm about to.
David, did you get it?
I didn't know.
You did. What did you get?
I didn't get one.
You've written.
I didn't. I've written 226, but that was based on 226. The other numbers I've written down are 100, 5, 3, 7, 1. Of those numbers, the closest to 226 is 100.
Okay, John, did you get it?
Yeah.
Sorry, what's happened to your voice?
Yeah, I got it, mate.
Joe, did you get it?
Yep. Yeah.
Joe, did you get it, though?
No.
What did you get, Joe?
Got 227, but there's absolutely no need to do the workings out.
OK, Roisin, did you get it?
I don't know.
No, she didn't.
I might have.
No, you haven't.
Well, how do you think you might have got it?
3 times 100.
Yeah.
And... Oh. Oh, I don't. No,
okay, John, how did you get it?
100 plus 9 plus 1 plus 3.
Oh, that's what I was going to.
113.
Multiplied by 7 minus 5.
Oh, for the 2. 226.
226. 10 points to John. Okay, the scores for the moment. Joe and Roisin have no points. John and David are on 17. And here is your teaser. The words are idle blow, the clue is give it a puff. That's idle blow, give it a puff. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were idle blow, the clue was give it a puff. It was, of course, billowed. So, John and David are in the lead. They've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for David and Joe. So David, your turn to choose the letters and then beat Joe at this game.
What's the maximum number of vowels allowed?
Five.
Five vowels.
Oh, you twat.
I-A-E-O. Oh,
can you spread them out?
And you.
Old MacDonald lost his marbles. I-A-E-O-U.
P-S-Q and N.
Lovely.
OK, and your time starts now. David, how many?
Four.
OK, Joe, you could snatch victory from the jaws of defeat here.
Four.
I've got five.
You weren't playing. What was your five there, Roisin?
Penis.
What, sorry?
Penis.
I've got a five.
I always spot the D. So I win, we get some points.
No, yeah. No, because you weren't playing that one. It was Joe versus David, and neither of them spotted the D. David, what was your four?
Soap.
Joe, what was your word? What was your four?
OAPs.
OK, so 4 points to David. Tom, Susie, could they have done any better?
They could have got a six with sequin.
Nice.
Oh.
Sequin. Gays love sequins.
They love penises as well, I would imagine.
You have one as well.
Oh, yeah, there's also sequoia is there for seven.
Lovely. What does that mean?
Sequoia tree. It's a redwood tree.
Hmm.
Sequoia.
OK. John, we should probably have another round of...
Fill
Your Happy Hole, or whatever it was called.
I'm moving it back, because...
What do you mean you're moving it back?
Well, it was too easy last time.
Why was it too easy?
Well, every time you get it, I'm going to move it back, because otherwise I will shit myself on telly.
I think for the ratings...
I don't think the ratings are going to go up if he shits himself. OK. All right, on three, everyone.
We all ready? I won't make you eat anything. I'm
just two,
enjoying
three.
The game.
Oh, fuck you guys.
Yay! Oh! Ah, what, Joe, what do you think
he
he's eating this time?
Second go! Attempt. That's second not attempt. Fair!
You have a choice between a lump
I'm
of
so
butter,
excited.
Lump of butter, cottage cheese, an onion.
I think the whole onion. If it's the
yeah.
whole onion.
Whole onion.
If, you,
whole
eat it like onion. A, if just... you eat it like an apple, then I think that's pretty fun.
I mean, I don't want to be that guy.
I think you're going to be the guy that shits himself.
I don't want to be...
Who is that
guy? I'm going to be that guy who won't eat an onion on telly. I just think, in the spirit of Fill My Hoop, I just think if it's the second go and it's you, I mean, I just don't think that counts.
If I'm going to eat it or not, come on.
Yes.
Eat it, eat it, eat it, eat it. Eat it. It's your game.
I think, for what it's worth, you absolutely shouldn't eat it.
I'm not eating the onion.
That people shouting, okay. Eat it, that's
a Nuremberg drama. I will pledge now, I will eat the onion if Joe or Roisin get a paper in on their first throw.
OK, can I have another go?
No, they can have a go in the next round.
Oh! Nuremberg!
OK, so at the end of that, Joe and Roisin have no points. John and David have 21. Right now, time for Roisin and John to go head-to-head. Roisin, your turn to pick the numbers. John, your turn to get them right.
Rachel, may I please have one from the top and five from the rest?
You may.
Thank you,
Roisin. One large, five little. There, right, we've got 3, 2, 7, 5, 9 and 100. And the target, 2, 3, 1.
And your time starts now. Okay, so the target was 2, 3, 1. Roisin.
I think I've got 2, 3, 2.
Oh, pretty close though.
Sure.
Pretty close. John, did you get it?
Yes, 231.
Okay, so how did you get it?
I know I didn't do it, but I think I've got it as well. That's really pissed me off.
Go on, how did you do it, Joe?
3 times 5.
You're 15. Still a way off.
Oh, hold on. No, carry on.
John, how did you do it?
100 plus 9 plus 5.
100 plus 9 plus 5, 114.
Multiplied by 2.
228.
And add the 3.
Yeah, cool. 2, 3, 1.
10 points to John.
Well
OK, time to go across the dictionary corner now. Tom, what have you got for us?
Well, thank you, Jimmy. Now, on this occasion, I thought I'd come up with a definition for you, actually, of a modern phenomenon. And the definition is competitive mourning. It refers to the modern trend of vying to be the most saddest at the death of a public figure or celebrity. Now, a few years ago, the world was made aware of the passing of one of its greatest ever leaders. His name was Nelson Mandela, and he was loved by people throughout the world. And on the day that he died, I happened to go online, and I saw a post from a girl I went to school with. Her name was Denise Queeve. And when I went on Facebook, I saw her post, and it said this: "Guys, Nelson Mandela has died." As though it was her news. As though she'd been phoned that morning by the Mandela family and told, "Denise, he's gone. We need you to tell the people." And duly, she went online, and underneath that, she wrote, "RIP." Just RIP. I think she was trying to write R.I.P., but she just put RIP, all lowercase. I mean, she liked the man, but not enough to hold down the shift key. And then underneath that, she wrote, "He was a great man." I mean, it's the most obvious thing in the world. It's like putting "The Queen suits pastels." Everybody knew that Nelson Mandela was a great man. The fact that she felt the need to put it there online suggested to me maybe she had some doubts. And then, underneath that, she put an emoticon. And the emoticon was this. "Guys, Nelson Mandela has died. RIP. He was a great man." And when you take a step back and you think of the sanctimonious, self-important, self-aggrandizement that it takes to go online and put something like that about the great man Nelson Mandela, I mean, it's narcissism. Of course, I clicked like because I didn't want to seem like a racist.
Come on, everyone. The scores at the moment, Joe and Roisin are doing great. They have no points. John and David have 31. They're slightly ahead. And here is your teaser. The words are turd cape. The clue is, I've got it. That's turd cape. I've got it. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were turd cape. The clue was, I've got it. It was, of course, captured. Now, before we move on, John, your paper ball game. Do you want to up the stakes?
Yeah, bring it. I sense there was a disappointment in the room that I didn't eat the onion.
OK, what about this? What about if we, against the clock, we all try and get, let's say, five bits of paper into the hoop, and if we do, you have to eat my specially prepared cake.
What do I get?
Diarrhea.
I've made a egg mayonnaise Victoria sponge with, and I think you'll enjoy this, mustard custard, which is it's custard made with mustard.
Oh my god!
Well, and that is It does smell a bit.
How long do you get?
Hour and
30 seconds.
Oh. And who's having a go? Seven of you.
Yes.
One each. So, what, a seven?
OK. So we've got seven in 30 seconds. OK, are we all ready? Are we ready with this?
They're bigger.
Where did this shit come from? Why are you all standing up?
Because this matters to us. OK, the time starts now.
Oh! Oh! Come on, yes!
Three.
Oh, it's going to be close. I think it's three.
Four.
Very nice.
Five.
You can't play mine. You can't play mine.
Oh. Oh, I'm not going to do it.
There it goes.
Yes. Yes.
I'm sorry, I got into the game.
So, I mean, great news. The mustard custard is, there's a whole, it'd be a shame to waste it.
Hold your nose, it'll taste like
oh my God, it's got a bit of a smell on it, hasn't it?
No, I would say two forkfuls.
Oh.
And that's before anything's happened.
Do you know what? Egg on your face. If this is delicious.
Good luck with that.
There's no way it smells like...
You've really gone for a Ganji bit, I admire that.
You're dipping it in.
Oh, John.
Come on, John.
Oh, God.
Just. You want an onion?
Oh, John. He's still chewing.
Why are you chewing? He
did. I hit him.
Okay, well, you're a very good sport there, so we're going to give you, John, one bonus point. Which I think puts you in the lead now.
If I eat an onion, do we get 32 points?
Yes!
Yes! Oh, yeah, yes!
Yeah, 100%, yeah.
Oh, my God, I'm so excited. We're going to win and we're going to get the unicorn.
I'll give you 30.
I told you it was our time!
Joe. Your time starts now.
Yes! Quick, hold your nose, hold your nose. Hold your nose, it'll be like an apple.
Stop that thing.
Joe, quick.
We've got so little time.
Just get it all in.
Shove it all in, then spit it out. Shove it all in, then spit it out. Shove it all in, look
at it. Joe.
Points?
I'm afraid you didn't finish, so no points, but great fun.
Sweating so much.
You better give me a point. I swear to God, I'm gonna burn this place down otherwise.
I think the mistake was the onion you had before we came out.
Oh, God, that was painful, and I'd go through bins.
OK, Joe, I'll give you 1 point.
Still smell it from your mouth.
Seriously, genuinely, have you never done that before?
No, why would I do that before?
You just seem like...
OK, on with the game. Joe and Roisin, your turn to choose the letters. Roisin, maybe you should do this.
May I have a consonant, please, Rachel?
You may. Thank you, Roisin. T.
Another consonant, please.
W.
A vowel, please, Rachel.
And an I.
A consonant, please, Rachel.
R.
A vowel, please.
O.
Another vowel, please, Rachel.
Oh, my God.
A.
Consonant, please.
N.
And a vowel, please.
E.
And another consonant, please.
And the last one. L.
OK, and your time starts now. David, how many letters?
Five.
John, how many letters?
Eight.
Joe?
I've got a five.
OK, Roisin?
Six.
No, how many did you get?
Six, no.
No.
No. Five.
OK, David, you're five?
Lona.
OK. Oh. Joe, you're five?
Try.
Roisin, you're five?
Right. W-R-I-T-E.
Yeah, that's all right.
John, you're eight.
Relation.
Brilliant.
Oh, relation. Huge. 8 points to John and David. OK, Tom, Susie, could they have done any better?
Yeah, there's just another 8 Oriental.
OK, so at the end of that, Joe and Roisin have 1 point. John and David are in the lead with 40. And here is your final teaser. The words are rude dong. The clue is not allowed to come out. That's rude dong, not allowed to come out. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were rude dong. The clue was not allowed to come out. It was, of course, grounded. OK, time for our final letters game. John and David, your turn to choose the letters.
Would you like to?
No, you've eaten a massive heap of shit.
You're a wolf. Thank you. Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, John. D.
Spotted that one, Roisin?
Leave it.
And another one, please.
Why?
And a vowel, please.
I.
Vowel, please.
E.
A consonant, please.
G.
Vowel, please.
O.
Consonant, please.
R.
And another one, please.
M.
And a vowel.
U.
OK, and your time starts now. Come on, put it in my mouth.
Such a dick.
Oh. Come on. You've got to ram it in.
You really do have to ram it in. John, how many letters?
So maybe a 5.
David?
4.
4?
I'm thrilled with it, though. Absolute peach.
OK, Joe, there's a bit of a chance here.
5.
5, OK. Roisin?
I've got no words.
No words. I mean, there's go up there.
I didn't even see that, Jimmy.
David, what was your 4?
The 4 is grim.
Grim.
I've got 6.
You've got 6.
Yeah, ooh. I had to think about it. I forgot myself.
Hang on, if now, I mean, if I.
You're 40 points ahead. You're going to be all right. Yeah. Well, John, what was your 5?
Well, if we're allowed to change to the one that Susie's showing us on that piece of paper, then I've got a 6 as well.
John! I'm trying to ruin Christmas!
This is we're playing. We're playing, let's remember. We're playing for a unicorn. Yeah. This is something that matters. This isn't just money or prominence or pride. This is a magical beast.
John, you're 5?
I don't know how you spell it, but you know those things. Well, I've got a lot in common. They're small and they irritate people during the summer. Midges, but like midge. A
yeah.
Midge.
Midge.
Joe, you're 5.
Domi.
Well, as in, like a dome?
Yeah, dome.
It's got dome-like, Joe, not domey.
Oh, I'll have dome-like.
Or domey.
Roisin, you're 6.
Gourd.
Gourd. You got gourd, did you?
No, I'm surprised.
He's spelling it with the E at the end.
Yes.
That's really clever.
Thanks, Katie.
Is it really clever, Susan? Because you're really clever.
Because that's not the thing that you eat. That is the basic monetary unit of Haiti, which obviously Roisin knew.
Yep.
OK, we're going to give you the points, Roisin. 6 points to Roisin! Tom, Susie, could they have done any better?
They could have done similar. No one could have done better than Roisin. They could have got morgue or rouged. Grimed is another one. Grimed.
OK, so Joe and Roisin have 7 points. John and David have 40 points.
Whoa.
Okay, fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's crucial countdown conundrum. And it is a crucial countdown conundrum because today the conundrum is worth 34 points. Hang on, let me look at the scores. That would mean you win.
Coincidence, isn't it?
Yeah, weird, right? Okay, and your time starts now.
I came in early.
Okay, we'll try again. Yes.
Lumbering.
Let's have a look and see if he's right. Yay! He's lumbering. So the final scores are Joe and Roisin have 7, John and David have 74. So congratulations, John and David. You're now the proud owner of this, the Countdown Unicorn. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Swoosh for Snow Cross. Sir Bradley Wiggins, Lydia Bright and co are back, but who will face the jump this time? Sunday at 7:30. Monday at 10, ready for a singles mixer. Cocktails are flowing as Celebs Go Dating returns for a new series, and so does Joey Essex. But next up, it's the last leg, live.